Breaking, Barack Obama just hauled off to court in Chicago. His long party is finally over. The moment he was elected President of the United States, Barack Obama's destructive reign of power began and even carried on into his post-presidential life. He's enjoyed all that holding office offered him at the cost of our country, but now that's all come to a screeching halt as he's being hauled off to court and won't be leaving anytime soon. Reality just caught up with him hard and it's going to hurt. Barack has always thought he was above the law and acted that way for 8 years, but now that he's not the leader of this nation and is officially a civilian like the rest of us, he's not being treated any differently. His ongoing vacations that began as soon as his presidency ended are now also over, and strangely, Michelle Obama is now nowhere to be found as her husband returns to their hometown to face the music. Although the list is long of everything that Barack should be held accountable for, there's just one reason why he's heading to court in Chicago. Cook County Chief Judge Tim Evans told county commissioners during a budget hearing on Friday that the former commander-in-chief, who owns homes in both Washington, D.C., and Chicago's Kenwood neighborhood, will serve in November, the Daily Mail reports. Barack is registered to vote in Chicago, a place he's practically abandoned as he leaves a legacy of crime to take over the city. However, there's no getting out of his civic obligation of jury duty, regardless of being a former president. Evans told the Chicago Tribune that necessary precautions would be taken to accommodate security and scheduling needs. He did not specify the date or courthouse location Obama will report to next month, Mail Online explained. Obama, who is registered to vote in Chicago, is not the first celebrity to serve jury duty in Cook County. In 2004, legendary talk show host Oprah Winfrey was called to serve for a Chicago murder trial. Jurors can be summoned for civil or criminal trials and can be called to any of the county's Chicago or suburban courthouses. Although it's not a place where the public can earn a lot of money, it is highly appreciated, Evans said of Obama's choice to serve, which will earn him just $17.20 per day, a far cry from what he's used to getting paid for speaking engagements and book deals. It's crucial that our society get the benefit of that kind of commitment, Evans added. Via Daily Mail. Obama will be following in the footsteps of presidential predecessors George W. Bush and Bill Clinton, both of whom appeared for jury selection after leaving the White House. Bush was summoned to the George Allen Dallas County Civil Court building in August 2015. Although not ultimately selected, he spent approximately 3 hours at the court and posed for photos with his fellow jury candidates. If the former president can show up for jury duty, what excuse do you have? #civic.com tweeted a spectator. In March 2003, Bill Clinton was prospective juror number 142 in federal court in Manhattan. The Associated Press reported that Clinton's name was never disclosed in a hearing, but his questionnaire answers, read aloud in the courtroom, provided the giveaway. Under previous jobs held, the respondent answered President of the United States. The case was eventually dismissed. Obama has been summoned for jury duty before in 2010, but he had to skip it as he was delivering the State of the Union address. Chances are, Barack will be tossed off the jury because he will draw far too much attention, just like he wants to and always does. He'll get out of yet another responsibility and go back to following his successor around in the shadows, trying to take him down for not leading the country into the ground as he did. If he doesn't immediately return to his house down the street from the White House, you can bet that he'll return to a vacation spot, far away from responsibilities and even his wife Michelle. The two of them haven't been seen together too much in recent months, as they spend more time apart than they do together. An insider who remains to be named has stated that Obama is loving the amateur life right now. If people thought there may have been struggles in his marriage to Michelle in the past, well, now those tiffs might be a bigger reality than we though. Some people thought he and Michelle were due for a divorce, but they didn't want to do that while he was serving as the commander-in-chief. And of course, they also had their daughters to worry about. But now the girls are grown and the Obama family is out of the White House, so what's the point in dragging things out if they don't need to be? The unknown source states that his wedding ring was off and now that he is out of the White House and OS&T have to keep up the sham image of a loving hubby, former President Barack Obama has kicked wife Michelle to the curb and has yanked off his wedding ring, a source claims. Obama was publicly hanging out with millionaire Richard Branson in Necker Island, loving every minute of the freedom and bachelor lifestyle away from Michelle. After partying up a storm with Virgin Airline mogul Richard Branson at his swanky Necker Island paradise, a source claims that Barack was gushing, "This is the life for me!" exclamation mark. Now, the former commander-in-chief wants to cut loose and party with billionaires like Branson and enjoy all the lovely young women they surround themselves with, comma snitches a source. Radar Online isn't he revealing who the source is, so we retaking this story with a grain of salt. Last time I saw the Obamas in the news, it was because they purchased a home in Washington, D.C. Would a couple preparing for divorce buy a new home together? And let us remind readers that one wild weekend with the boys OS&T mean everyone is running to their lawyers talking about a divorce. We need to tread lightly on this story until someone reveals who the source is. I can T fully back this story until Radar Online tells everyone who their source is. On the other hand, if there's an Obama divorce that pops up in the news in the next week or so, then Radar Online was right on the money.